Come learn with me. 4, 5, 6. Calendar and weather pick. 7, 8, 9. It's circle time.
We're gonna clap. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Side to side.
One, two, three, come learn with me. 4, 5, 6, calendar and weather pick. 7, 8, 9, it's circle time.
Now we're gonna stomp. Stomp, 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 stomp. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow. Side to side.
One, two, three, come learn with me. 4, 5, 6, calendar and weather pick. 7, 8, 9, it's circle time.
Now we're gonna jump. Jump, jump, run in place. Turn around and then sit down.
Hello, my friends, hello. Hello, my friends, hello. Hello, my friends, hello, my friends, hello, my friends, hello, hello. Hi, everybody. Let's get started with our calendar. Do you know what's first? It's our monthly Macarena. Let's do it all together. January, February, March, and April, May, June, July, and August, September, October, November, and December. These are the months of the year. We have a new month. Do you remember what it is? It starts with the letter J for June. Nice job. It's the month of June. Now, let's figure out the day of the week. There are 7 days, there are 7 days, there are 7 days in a week. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Now, if yesterday was Wednesday, that means today is Thursday. Good work. It's Thursday today. We need to figure out what this number is. Let's count all together, starting at number 1, 2, 3, 4. Today is the 4th. Let me find it. Number 4. Wait a second. That's better. Now 4 goes right beside the 3. We know it's June, Thursday, the 4th, and the year is 2020. Now let's put it together in a big date sandwich. Today is Thursday, June the 4th, 2020. Nice work. Give yourself a big pat on the back and let's move on to our weather. What's the weather? What's the weather? What's the weather like today? Is it sunny? Is it rainy? Is it cloudy out today? Is it windy? Is it snowy? Is it stormy out today? What's the weather? What's the weather? What's the weather like today? Take a look outside and tell me what the weather's like.
5 big whales. 5 big whales in the sea offshore. One swam up to spout and that left 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 big whales in the deep blue sea. One swam up to spout and that left 1, 2, 3. 3 little whales in the sea so blue. One swam up to spout and that left 2. 2 big whales having lots of fun. One swam up to spout and that left 1. 1 big whale longing for the sun. It swam up to spout and that left 9. The month of the year in Spanish. Are you ready? Enero, febrero, marzo, abril, mayo, junio, julio, agosto, septiembre, octubre, noviembre, diciembre. Estos son los meses del año. Cha, cha, cha.
Boys and girls, five little fish. Can you help me count the fish? One, two, three, four, and five. Five little fish were swimming in the sea, teasing Mr. Sharky Shark. You can't catch me. Along came Mr. Sharky Shark, quiet as can be. Snap! Uh-oh, how many fish do we have left? One, two, three, four. Four little fish were swimming in the sea, teasing Mr. Sharky Shark, you can't catch me. Along came Mr. Sharky Shark, sneaky as can be. Snap! How many fish do we have left? One, two, and how many? Three, that's right. Three little fishies were swimming in the sea, teasing Mr. Sharky Shark, you can't catch me. Along comes Mr. Sharky Shark, sneaky as can be. Ooh, which one's he gonna catch? Snap! Uh-oh, how many fish are left? Not very many. One and two. That's right. You guys are good counters. Very well done. Two little fishies were swimming in the sea, teasing Mr. Sharky Shark. You can't catch me. Oh, yes? Along comes Mr. Sharky Shark. Sneaky as can be. Snap! Uh-oh. Now we only have one fish left, let's make sure. Just one, that's right. One little fish was swimming in the sea, teasing Mr. Sharky Shark, you can't catch me. Along comes Mr. Sharky Shark, sneaky as can be. Snap! Oh, miss me, miss me. Now you need to hug me. Okay, I love to hug my friends. Best friends. The end. And that is the story of the five little fishes and Mr. Shark.
Today, we're learning about letter H, and I'm going to read Hide and Seek Hippo by Samantha Berger.
Hide and Seek Hippo. Have you seen baby hippo? It's time for him to come home. He must be somewhere. Hee hee hee. Is he hiding in hummingbird's honeysuckle? Shh, I'm hiding. Is he hiding in hedgehog's hole? Hey! Is he hiding in hare's hutch? You're huge! Is he hiding in the hen's house? Hee hee hee, it's hatching. Is he hiding in horse's haystack? Hippo, hi. Is he hiding behind the honeybee's hive? Humph, find your own honey. Is he hiding in the hyena's hideaway? I'm hungry. Hungry for hippo hot dogs. Hurry back, help! Where could baby hippo be hiding? Mother hippo has something for him. Here I am. A great big hippo hug. Hip, hippo, hooray! How many things can you find that begin with the letter H? I see something back here. It's a house. This farmer is holding a hamburger. We have a hen, a hippo, a horse, and even a hive. What else can you find? Here I have some things that begin with the letter H. I have a horse, a hamster, a hat, a hexagon, lowercase h, and a hand. Now, I'm going to take away one of these things, and it's your job to tell me what's missing. Close your eyes and do not peek. Open them up. This one's a hard one. It was small. It has five fingers, and it starts with the letter H. It's a hand. High five. Good job. Close your eyes again. Open them up and tell me what's missing. It goes on your head. It's a hat. Nice work. Let's play one more time. Close your eyes. Open them up. What's missing? I'll give you a clue. It's an animal. It has long, luscious hair. Sometimes we call it a pony, but it's a horse. Nice work, everyone.
Let's learn how to write letter H. We're going to start with uppercase, and then we'll move to lowercase. Uppercase, lowercase. To do our letter H in uppercase, we need to start at the top. We start with a long line down. And then, the easy part is we match that on the other side, across from it. Start at the top and make another line down. Now, what is it missing? Just our middle line across to connect the two sides. Nice work. Now, we're going to do our lowercase H. Same way we started with our uppercase, a long line down. But now, we need a hump. Start in the middle and come all the way down. Kind of like a mountain. Nice work. Now, let's do it all together. Are you ready? We start at the top and we go down. And then we start at the top again and we go down. And then we do a line across. Ta-da! Wait a second, that's not right. Let's come back to that in a minute. Let me practice my lowercase H. Line down. And now we just need that hump. Ta-da! Wait a second, that's the wrong way. I think I need your help. Let's try that again, one more time, all together. We start at the top for our uppercase H. We do a long line down. Now we need another one. Now do you remember what comes next? It's a line across. And where is that line? Is it at the bottom? No. Is it at the top? No. It's in the middle. Try it with me. Good work. Now let's do our lowercase H. The same line all the way down. And then we need to do our hump. Which way does it go? Does it go that way towards Miss Graham? No, it goes away from us. Nice work.
Hi everyone. Let's practice our letter H writing worksheet for today. To get yours, click the link below. First, don't forget to write your name. Mine's already up. Then we're going to go down here. I've written uppercase, lowercase, uppercase, lowercase, so we can practice. To do your uppercase, don't forget. One line down, another line down, and one right across. Use the lines to help you out. Go from the top to the top to the bottom, and straight across the middle line. Keep going all the way to the end. Make sure you do it in the same steps over and over and over again. Oops. Try and write it as neatly as possible. Then you can move on to your lowercase H. For lowercase, we start at the top again. We go all the way down, and then we're going to do our hump right in the middle. Again, you can use the line for a guide. Try not to go past that middle line. From the top to the bottom, and then a hump, small enough to reach the middle line. And you're going to go all the way to the end. You can keep going below. After you're done, draw something that starts with the letter H. Let's see if you can guess what I'm going to draw. Do you know what it is yet? Here, let me add a door. Do you know? It has a roof, it has windows. It might even have a tree out front, and it could be all different kinds of colors. What do you think it is? It's a house, and I'm going to write that word below. House. Whatever you end up drawing that starts with letter H, you can practice writing below. Good job, everyone.
Hi, everybody. Let's learn our letter H chant and how to sign letter H all together. To sign letter H, take your hand, put it out in front of you, and make sure you put your two fingers together and put it out like this. Good job, just like this. Just let your fingers fall into place. Now let's learn our letter H chant. It goes like this. H is for honeybee, H is for hen. H is for hogs in a pen. H is for hiccups, hug, hat, and horse. H is for hula hoop and hippo, of course. Hooray for H, big and small, the happiest and hoppiest letter of all.
Lots of little fish were sleeping on a rock in the bottom of the ocean. They used their threads and they shook out their tails and they said, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean. Then the little fish got so very, very tired that they came back to the rock. They put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up, they were a little bit dirty, so they took a shower. And they washed their hair, and they washed their ears, and they washed their tummies, and they washed their very long fishy beards, and they washed their noses, and they washed their toeses, and then they said, wait a minute, we're fish!
We
don't take showers! Let's go swimming! Let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean. Then the little fish got so very, very tired that they came back to the rock. They put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up, they decided to ride their bicycles. So they rode to the left, and they rode to the right, and they rode all day, and they rode all night. They rode down the hill, and then faster still, and then they said,
wait a minute, we're fish.
We're gonna ride bicycles. Let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean. Then the little fish got so very, very tired that they came back to the rock. And they put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up, they decided to brush their teeth. So they got out their toothbrush and their toothpaste. And they squeeze a little on. They really like the taste. Then they put it in their mouth. They brush north and south. And then they said,
Wait a minute, we're fish.
We don't brush our teeth. Let's go swimming.
Let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean. Let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean.
boys and girls. We have a story today called Whoosh, A Watery World of Wonderful Creatures. And the author, that's the lady who wrote the book, is called Marilyn Bale. So let's begin. When you swim in the sea or splash in your bath, do you ever wonder what water creature you like to be? Turn the page to see the amazing animals that love water, just like you. I am a playful dolphin leaping high out of the sea. I use my dolphin talk to keep in touch with my friends. Squeak, whistle, click, click, click. Those are the sounds the dolphin makes. I am a water strider, but guess why I'm called the magic bug? I can race across lakes and ponds. My light body and long legs help me walk on the water. Does that seem like magic to you? Look at, she's floating on the water too. Shh, I'm a great blue heron fishing for my supper. Silently, I keep watch through the ripples. Splash, in a flash, my long, strong beak catches a wriggling fish. Slurp, I swallow it down whole. And the boy and his dad are fishing also, just like the heron. I am a tired alligator, cruising and keeping cool in the river. When it's time for my nap, I flop onto the rocks and snooze the day away. Just like, see the girl on the purple water floaty? She's doing the same thing. Have a little rest, just like the alligator. I am a river otter pup. My mom pulls me into the chilly water for my first swimming lesson. Patiently, she teaches me to paddle and dive. Look at me float. And the girl is floating too with her mom at swimming lessons. Oh, this is very cool. I am an orca whale swimming up for air. When I breathe out through my blowhole, I send a fountain of spray. Whoosh! Just like these kids. Look at the fountain of spray is coming out of the sprinkler. I am a hermit crab hunting for a home. On a sandy seabed, I slip into an empty shell and settle down to stay. Feels just right. And I am a baby elephant having a bath with my mom. It's been a long, hot walk to our favorite watering hole. Swoosh! Oh, it's so nice and cool. Spray me more! And there's the boy having spray from his mom. They're just the same. I am a clownfish. I bet you've seen a fish like this before. And I stay safe in the sea anemone's stinging tentacles. I flutter about and I look from my hiding spot. Peekaboo! I am not just any penguin. I am an emperor penguin. When I go fishing with my friends, we love to slide on our sleek bellies and dive into the ocean. It's like going down the water slide. I bet you can't guess that I'm a shark, but I am. I'm a tasseled wobblegong shark. I fool these fish too with my seaweed disguise. Still as a stone, I wait at the bottom of the reef and then chomp, I catch my dinner. Water is precious to me and to you and to all living things. Can you think of some of the ways that we use water? Look at, they're in the bathtub, they're making their sandcastles, they're watering their plants. Those are all ways. And that is the story of Whoosh. I hope you enjoyed it.
Thanks for joining me today. That's all we have time for. So join me in singing the goodbye song.
Our day is done, we had so much fun.